To learn about the off-grid lifestyle and to be inspired to live your dreams, click subscribe so you don't miss anything. Hit the bell notification. I thought I'd try something a little different today. So I thought I would do a video where I test the cheapest chainsaw from Home Depot. But what I have here is a Ryobi 14-inch chainsaw. It's the smallest one they had. It was $119 at Home Depot. Now here's what I did. I just wanted a chainsaw. I wanted a cheap one. And the town that has Home Depot also has a Menards and a Lowe's. So we went to all three stores. Went to Menards and their cheapest chainsaw was sold out. Then we went to Lowe's. Again, their cheapest chainsaw was sold out. So far, I'm very happy with the chainsaw. It's only 37 cc's and it's only got a 14-inch blade. Now, there's two reasons why I got such a cheap, small chainsaw. One was I'm not that experienced on chainsaws. The biggest experience I had was with my grandparents and my father. We'd go out and they'd cut down the trees. And I would just kind of cut the limbs off. So I always operated small chainsaws, and this is what I'm pretty used to. I recognize that if I got a steel chainsaw, 20-inch bar, I'd probably be a lot more satisfied, I'd have a lot more power, but I'd also think I'd be a lot less safe. Now, the second reason is these cheap chainsaws, you can buy lots of them. You know, I don't know how much a steel chainsaw is, $500, I don't know. But this one's $100, $119. And I can buy two or three or four of them, still not beat the price of the steel chainsaw. So my grandpa's philosophy was buy a bunch of them. And that way, if you hit a rock while you're out cutting trees down, just switch out chainsaws. You don't have to stop what you're doing, waste time sharpening the blade. That's something you do at night when it's dark. He had a little workbench behind the kitchen table and he'd set it up and he'd sharpen the blades. I've had one other chainsaw in my adult life. It was a Poland Wild Thing. I bought it in 2001. It still runs. I really didn't use it very often. I've used it maybe two summers. The Wild Thing is a little bit bigger. I think it's an 18-inch, so I'd be able to get bigger trees. This one is fantastic for what we've been using it for. We've been just cutting down deadfall so far, but most of the trees are well under 14 inches. 12 inches is probably the most that I've cut, and this thing handles them very well. I'm very happy with it. The one thing that I was really struggling with, I was almost ready to give up on this thing. I was thinking, there's just something wrong with this chainsaw, was the chain that came on it is right here. And it's junk. This thing is absolutely junk. It dulls almost immediately. You probably can last one tank of gas and then it becomes dull. Well, it's been so long since I operated a chainsaw. I think the last time I operated a chainsaw was, oh gosh, I don't know, 10 years ago maybe? I thought I knew how to sharpen a chainsaw. But when I got to this thing, I was really struggling with it. And got the guide on the file and I'd be doing everything I'm supposed to be doing at the right angle and it just wasn't working. What I noticed though was there's a blade on each side. There's a blade here and then there's a blade here. So one is angled this way, one is angled the other way. Well, actually it's like that. And so you sharpen from one side and then you switch sides and you sharpen the other side. The problem with this is I think one of the sides is smaller than the other side. One side holds this very well, and you don't have any problem sharpening one side of it, but you get to the other side, it doesn't fit right. I was taking the file out of the guide, and I was manually doing it. And I was doing okay, but like I said, it would still go dull within the first tank of gas. Well, the other day, I hit a rock with this. Which I've hit rocks before too, and I've been able to sharpen the blade right back to new, and it did fine. But I sharpened this blade, and it wouldn't sharpen. So I tried again, and it wouldn't sharpen. Tried again. I tried it three times, and it just wouldn't sharpen. It just would not cut wood. It was smoke. It was burning the wood good. So I switched blades. I bought a two-pack of Oregon, I think it's called. Now, this is what all the YouTubers suggest that you buy. This is, I guess, top of the line, O-R-E-G-O-N chainsaw blades. And there's it came in a two-pack for $24, so $12 a piece. I put that thing on, man, it cut like butter. This thing did a fantastic job once I put the new blade on. I was able to sharpen the blades again. As a matter of fact, they don't dull very much, but I kind of, you know, touch up, easy to sharpen. Both sides are even, like they're supposed to be. This was at Home Depot as well, so I had to invest an extra $12. So the grand total of this chainsaw isn't $119. It's $131 because you got to get the extra blade. The items that the chainsaw comes with, it comes with a blade cover. Now, there's no case for it, so it just slides on there. I suppose you have to buy the case separately or something. I put it on there just so I don't ding it around while I'm carrying it around. Now, about every 3 days, I turn the blade upside down and then upside right, upside down. You can do that. You're supposed to do that. That way the blade, the bar, wears evenly. As you cut, you're putting pressure in one spot of the blade. But on the other side, there's nothing being pushed on. So the top side of this blade is perfectly fine. But on the bottom side, you're really wearing it out. So if you swap it back and forth, you'll get to keep your bar much longer. Other reason I use this is I flip it upside down when the blade's upside down. That way, I don't know, it just helps me remember that it's upside down right now and three cuttings. I need to flip it back upside right. So then I flip it back upside right. It also came with a screwdriver multi-tool wrench. This thing is handy when you have to take the blade off. So on this side, you have to take this cover off to get the blade off, flip it over, to take the chain, replace the chain off. Also, see, this is actually kind of loose. You have to loosen this, these two nuts right here. And then there's a screw right here that you tighten. And see, now the blade's a lot tighter. Now you have to do that when the chain is new. This Oregon chain doesn't need tightening very often. And so you should be able to snap right back like that. When you're sharpening the blade, make sure you wear gloves because this is sharp enough that if you slipped, it can cut your fingers pretty good. The blade that came with it needed tightening all the time. The chains stretch. This one must stretch a mile. I would have to tighten it almost every time I put gas into it. That chain is junk. It comes in with a 2.6 ounces of this type of fuel oil. So you mix in 2.6 ounces of this oil into gasoline. The instructions say to use this ethanol shield brand, which is what comes with it. You buy this at Home Depot. This is really good stuff because it actually stabilizes the gasoline. So it's gasoline stabilizer and oil. Maintenance is pretty easy on this. The air filter is easy. You just pop this little thing up here. The cover pops right off and the air filter snaps right off. And there's the air filter. It's a little dirty. I just washed it yesterday. Now what you do is you just take some Dawn dishwashing soap and you wash it with Dawn dishwashing soap. And then you put a little bit of oil in it, squeeze the oil in it real good. That helps capture all the dirt particles. I love these foam air filters. Saves a lot of money. The one I saw on YouTube, you have to replace. You have to buy and replace. I don't think they're washable. And the thing is these chainsaws are disposable. They're not designed to last a lifetime. So $100. Think about how much heating would cost if you use propane. Let's say it was $800 to heat with propane. Even if you had to replace this every year, that's $100. Very cheap in comparison to propane. However, I've cut 3 cords of wood, and I suspect that's about all that I'm going to need. I'm going to keep going, and this thing's still operating like new. Somebody asked me if it could split a log, so I tried it today, and it does. It splits a log. It's not great. It used quite a bit of gas doing it, so I wouldn't suggest that you do it. I think you want to get a wood splitter. It's much more efficient and faster. Now, I wouldn't have tried it with this old blade. I would have told the guy, no, it wouldn't work. But this new blade, I thought I'd give it a try. Yeah, so I cut up, 6 or 7 logs. in the quarters, so four pieces, and it probably took me a half hour. Here's what I would say about this chainsaw, is if you're gonna just start out your off-grid lifestyle and you want a chainsaw, this is a really good starter chainsaw. The Poland I was telling you about, the Wild Thing, it's hard to start. Parts are already broken on it. Like I said, I only used it maybe two summers, maybe. And the screw that tightens the blade is already broke. So I got to really get a bar screwdriver in there and tighten it up. And it's not easy to use. Again, this one I've abused quite a bit just in the few weeks that I've had it. And there is no signs that there's any problems with it. I hope I inspire you to go out and really try to cut some firewood for your off-grid living. Thanks for watching.